Mr. Chairman, this, and to the folks watching here, this slog continues. Last week, I urged you and my fellow members of the Judiciary Committee Democrats to respect the histories and traditions of this committee and conduct its business accordingly. We still have a crisis on our southern border. China is stealing our intellectual property. Yet here we are, wasting another valuable week of legislating calendar against the majority's war against the administration. Today, we are meeting to consider a resolution to hold Attorney General Bill Barr in contempt of Congress. So let's take just a few moments and go through this. What is the justification for holding Attorney General Barr in contempt of Congress? Perhaps that he failed to abide by the special counsel regulations? No, he went above and beyond what the regulations required by transmitting the full report to Congress with limited redactions. Could it be that the Attorney General failed to accommodate the chairman's demands for information? No. He offered to let the chairman and five other Democrat leaders review the less redacted report at the Department of Justice, including a 99.9% unredacted volume on obstruction. In an odd move for anyone demanding access to information, the chairman and the other elected Democrats given access have declined to view that report. The Attorney General also volunteered to testify before this committee about the report's conclusions and his role in sharing the report. And as we all witnessed, the Democratic gamesmanship forced the Attorney General to forego the scheduled hearing last week. On Monday, the Justice Department offered to meet to discuss accommodations. Yesterday, they made a reasonable offer to avert this spectacle, and once again, they were rebuffed and the chairman declined. Perhaps then the Democrats believe that there has been an unreasonable delay in the Justice Department's response to their subpoena. No, that's not true either. In fact, the chairman is moving to this contempt resolution at lightning speed. It has been less than 20 days since the chairman, Nadler, subpoenaed documents from the Justice Department. When the Oversight Committee held Attorney General Eric Holder in contempt, more than 250 days had passed between the subpoena and the committee's vote to hold him in contempt. More than 450 days passed between the committee's initial request to the Justice Department and the committee's contempt vote. Judiciary Democrats are moving more than 10 times faster than Oversight did with Holder. They have moved from request to contempt vote in only 43 days. And yet the Justice Department is still at the negotiating table waiting for the Democrats to arrive in good faith. Why this rush? Without any valid legislative or administrative reason, we can only assume the Democrats that are led by the chairman have resolved to sully the Bill Barr's good name and reputation to accomplish two goals. First, Democrats are angry the special counsel's report did not produce the material or collusions they expected to pave their path to impeaching the president. I feel compelled to remind everyone the report found, despite offers to do so, no one from the Trump campaign knowingly conspired with the Russian government. And you can't help but notice the phrase Russian collusion has vanished from the Democratic talking points and left a void in the narrative. Since the special counsel did not make a prosecutorial determination on obstruction, which was his job, the Attorney General and the Deputy Attorney General did so according to their mandates as law enforcement officials while giving no credence to the Office of Legal Counsel's opinion regarding that of sitting presidents. As a result, they're angry. They're angry our nation's chief law enforcement officer and his deputy had the audacity to decide the evidence didn't support charges for obstruction and investigation into something the president didn't do. Second, Democrats are afraid of what the Attorney General will find when he completes his ongoing review of FISA abuses at the Justice Department, including how the Russia investigation began. Multiple news reports have suggested those conclusions could be explosive, could end careers, and could even lead to criminal prosecution. Rather than face that, the Democrats have resolved to neutralize Bill Barr by attacking him and the office and his integrity and his career. This is the first step. What a cynical, mean-spirited, counterproductive, irresponsible step it is. Meanwhile, our economy is surging, unemployment among several minority groups is at historic low, a recent Washington Post poll shows cratering support for impeachment, but Democrats have no plans, no purpose, and no viable legislative agenda beyond attacking this administration. The House is more than 4 months into a Democratic majority. How many bills passed by this committee have been signed into law? Mr. Chairman, I implore you to see reason. I ask that you recognize the craven and insincere politics that seem to be yielding no dividends for the American people. We've talked on multiple occasions and proved at last week's pharmaceutical markup that I stand ready to work with you to promote solutions. I will not, though, become a bystander as we assail the Attorney General and this committee. Our democracy deserves better. Finally, Mr. Chairman, I'd like to quote a fellow member of Congress. As a member of Congress, I treat assertions of executive privilege very seriously. I believe they should be used only sparingly. In this case, it seems to clear the administration was forced into a position by the committee's insistence on pushing forward with contempt. Despite the Attorney General's good faith offer, Mr. Chairman, it did not have to be this way. We could have postponed today's vote and accepted the Attorney General's offer. Instead, by not honoring the Constitution's charge to seek accommodations when possible, the prestige of this committee has been diminished. As a result, that should concern us all. I quote Elijah Cummings. In that case, of course, the committee did seek accommodations. In this case, this committee did not. And in just a difference of opinion between me and the chairman, there has been no escalation of this except on the side of the majority. You have to have both sides at the table for accommodations. That's the way this process works. That is what I've just laid out, 10 times faster than even Eric Holder. And when we get into the other issues that have been discussed here, and again, how we deal with this is going forward with what will be the precedent for the future and will be the precedent for what we have. With that, I yield back.